Acting!
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 Love it.
Nothing elevates a film like a great character. And no great character can exist without a great performance.
It's called acting.
In part one of this series, we looked at the crucial relationship between actors and directors, discovering how great performances come to be.
I'm a star!
In this video, we'll go even deeper into the process, learning from legendary directors in their own words. This is How to Direct Actors, Part 2. Before we get started, subscribe to StudioBinder and click the bell to stay up to date on all our filmmaking videos. Let's begin.
You're like an amazing actor, man.
A director must often wear many hats, and this requires having knowledge in a variety of fields. A bit of production design, camera work, lighting, and writing, to name a few.
It has to stop.
I'm sorry.
Different directors excel in different areas. As David Cronenberg notes,
there are so many aspects to filmmaking, it would be very rare for a director to really be superb in every element. I mean, are you great with actors and also great with the camera and also great with music and also great with choreography? Not necessarily. That means you have to accept the collaborative element of filmmaking.
Special order from Escort Embassy.
I'm Mimsy, and this is my sister, Coral.
But perhaps the most important role for a director is working with actors. The director will consult with the production designer for production design and the director of photography for cinematography. But a performance comes from just the collaboration between the director and the actor. Directors' approaches to working with actors can take many forms, depending on the performer and the nature of the project. But whatever the approach, there are typically three distinct stages in the actor-director relationship, beginning with the intersection of writing and casting. It's hard to have a great performance without a good script. A director needs to be a strong reader, developing a deep understanding of each character in order to make smart casting decisions.
Action!
Of course, some directors have also written the script. This, too, affects their casting decisions. Writer-director Wong Kar-Wai argues that working with actors begins with writing for them.
The best way to work with an actor or actress is to customize the role for him, because you can borrow something from that person. And in a way, then the experience or the performance will be unique.
Nancy Meyers uses her actors as writing inspiration. Like when she was writing for Diane Keaton and Jack Nicholson.
Okay, you stay where you are. We have a knife.
No, no, you don't understand. I'm a friend of your daughter's.
Yeah, I don't think so.
I had their pictures all over my computer. And when I would really get stuck, I would go online to their website, seriously. And I'd see like Diane on a red carpet somewhere, and I'd see a look on her face. I'd think, oh yeah, okay, I'm back.
I really like you.
I really like you.
Yeah, but I love you like you. I do. I love you.
Conversely, Pedro Almodóvar has more trepidation towards this approach.
Pues en general, es decir, la escritura del guion siempre es una cosa misteriosa y abstracta, y pocas veces he escrito papeles pensando en actores concretos. O sea, cuando lo he hecho ha sido ya cuando tenía ya una relación muy larga con los actores.
Esto está muy bien, ¿eh?
Paul Thomas Anderson, meanwhile, writes scripts in a way that allows him to get better performances out of his actors.
My first job is to be a really good writer to the actors. To not describe it in the script. So many times you see so much description of what the character is supposed to be feeling and stuff in screenplays, and it's just a big mistake. It has to be done through dialogue and what they do. I think the actors really appreciate that. It lets them do their job.
Make it happen. This is you, Donnie. Go.
said in the middle of the night, I said, if I could talk to the animals,
I believe in my
daughter. Really, really talk to them.
For Mike Lee, the final script for a project is the result of months of collaboration with the actors.
I, you know, work individually with the actors, and we have a sort of rehearsal base, and we work for months before we get to shoot the film. And for most of my films, when you see them, you'll see that there's a whole collection of backstories, and we developed all of those to arrive at the time present.
When, how will the world ever...
And?
Yes!
Kiyoshi Kurosawa notes that by just meeting with an actor, he can get new ideas for not only the characters they could play, but also the stories he can tell. He explains how his relationship with actor Sho Aikawa enabled him to experiment with new genres. The director, however, isn't the only one with a say in the casting process. Actors may be attached to projects through producers before a director even signs on. In Barbie, for example, Margot Robbie was attached and recommended the team bring on Greta Gerwig. Directors will also often rely on casting directors for finding exciting talent to fill out the roles. Spike Lee credits his casting directors for finding stars before they're stars.
I don't need a casting director to say, we should get Denzel Washington for this movie. Duh! Tell me the people I don't know! They should be Academy Awards for casting.
Yo, babe, bruh! Cyrus! Black man! Successful in shit. I want y'all to meet my new woman, Viv. That's short for Vivian. Good people. I like her.
Once casting is complete, the work has only just begun.
Okay, kid, you got the job.
Directors and actors then embark on preparation.
Look, hey, this is what I do.
Stop on hey and check him out.
That's what I do. It's so idiot with a claw hammer.
I stop on hey, idiot.
Yeah. Hey, go ahead. Hey, this is what I do. If some idiot with a claw hammer could knock his way through there, you think I would still have a job?
Typically, a performance doesn't just happen on set. As Richard Linklater notes, even the most spontaneous scenes are a result of laying the groundwork of a character with an actor.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, not turn.
Yeah, my biggest compliment is how the viewer might think it's improvised. Like, oh, you just turn on camera and that happened.
Yeah, now raise your goblet of rock. It's a toast to those who rock.
That's a compliment, because we work really hard to make it feel that way. Between the actor and myself, my biggest compliment is for the actor to feel like they wrote the scene or they contributed so much that it's them.
That's what I love about these high school girls, man. I get older, they stay the same age.
Yes, they do.
Extensive work before shooting can allow directors to let actors have more freedom on set. Lee Isaac Chung employed this approach with his actors on Minari, especially for more emotionally demanding scenes.
I just gave them a lot of freedom. We prepared a lot beforehand with a lot of conversation before they did it, and I knew that we were getting amazing things.
It often takes months of work beforehand to make sure the actor and director are on the same page. Different directors have different strategies for helping their actor prepare for a performance. Guillermo del Toro will supplement his script with detailed descriptions of each character and listen to his actor's input.
I would deliver to her an 8-page biography that details her zodiac sign, what she eats, what she doesn't eat, what music she listens to, and the biography from birth to the end of the movie. And then the actor, you say, ignore anything that doesn't work, but if there's anything in there that works, let's talk about it.
Robert Eggers has a similar approach. Though because he favors films set in specific time periods, he sends actors primary sources to borrow from. He describes his process for The Lighthouse.
I give them a lot of my research, but tailored to their role. And each role requires different things, and each actor requires different things. Both of them got like copious amounts of dialect instruction, but obviously for different dialects.
I seen it. You're fond of me lobster.
And I did give Willem some documentaries and books and things about lighthouse keeping.
And say to the rest of your dukies, you're behind hand already.
Aye, sir.
You're too slow. You a dullard?
No, sir.
Fooled me.
Preparation also allows for a director and their actors to understand each other's vision and craft. This foundation will often prove to be crucial when the pressures of long hours and ever-moving logistics come into play during production. For Patty Jenkins, getting a comprehensive feel for her actor's mentality before filming is critical.
I am so interested in what makes people tick, and so it makes it a very enjoyable relationship on many levels, because I'm genuinely interested in, wow, that's interesting. I didn't think that would go that way. And then I'm talking to the actor, well, let's try this other thing and see how that works, you know? So that dialogue about like, wow, that's funny. I didn't think that resistance would result in feeling like that.
And I didn't want to die thinking that maybe he could have loved me. So I killed him. I shot him, all right?
Because the working relationship between actors and directors can be so valuable, many directors will return to certain performers again and again.
It's payday, boys.
Julie Dash had a returning cast for much of her work, helping build a community that became known as the LA Rebellion film movement. When she had a larger budget for the landmark Daughters of the Dust, she knew she wanted to take that cast with her.
For this one, I really wanted to cast people who had come along over the years and worked with us, because this was the first time I was going to be able to pay people. We had $800,000 to make the film, and I didn't want to just go out into the, you know, cast other actors. I wanted to finally be able to pay back some of the actors who had worked with us over the years.
Pedro! Pedro! Herb's gonna change nothing. Done gonna spoil everything. All used to do it this way, don't have none today.
This communal approach can help build a mutual trust between a director and actor. As Mira Nair explains, this can be hugely important for an actor to be so comfortable being vulnerable on set.
Why would a dancer let her into your life if she doesn't trust you? Why would she open herself up? So that ability to create a safe space where you can take risks and fall on your face, that is very essential for the director first to create.
Preparation can go beyond just discussions. Many directors will run rehearsals so that they can give notes and the actors can get into character before the pressure of the camera is introduced. For David Lynch, rehearsals are a way to get in sync with an actor.
You have that first rehearsal, it's either spot on or very close, or we got a lot of work to do. Then you talk to them so that that character they catch the same way you caught it. And they say, ah, okay. And the way you do that is you have rehearsals.
Very good. Really?
I mean, it was forced maybe, but still humanistic. Yeah, very good. Really, really.
Rehearsals can also be important for developing the relationship between the actors themselves. Charlotte Wells notes this was a goal for Paul Mescal and Frankie Corio in the prep work for After Sun.
We had 2 weeks where they just spent kind of on holiday together, getting to know each other. I don't think anyone but Paul would have put in what he put into building that relationship.
And there's this feeling, once you leave where you're from, like where you grew up, that you don't totally belong there again. Not really.
The preparation process, in whatever form it may take, can be extremely beneficial for both the director and actor. Once this stage is complete, it's time for both parties to start working on set.
I want a man that makes my blood run cold.
Collaborating with an actor on set is perhaps the most delicate aspect of the actor-director relationship. This is when the performance will be written in stone. It's now or never to get it right.
Where are you going? Huh?
This is why some directors, like David Fincher, will have an actor do a high volume of takes. Fincher argues that this process is also beneficial to an actor's overall performance.
My process is about, I'm going to give you 17, 18, 25 bites at the apple, because if you're smart and if you're conscientious, you've worked out in your head as an actor what it is you want to present me. And so what I want to do is go, great, show me that. We're going to shot 7 takes. Okay, now let's start. Now I want to get beyond muscle memory.
Amy, you can teach those people to hate me all you want. I don't care. I am leaving you.
I won't have to teach your child to hate you. He'll do that all by himself.
I'm the one you married. The only time you liked yourself was when you were trying to be someone this might like.
Michelangelo Antonioni, however, espoused the opposite approach. For him, fewer takes would often result in a performance which felt more authentic. I never film a lot, only 3 or 4 takes per scene. I want the actors to be fresh, not tired. This way they are more natural. Many times, the first take is the best.
What do we do then?
I send you the photographs.
No, I want them now.
Now! What's the rush?
The best performances also come from actors who feel comfortable on set. As Jonathan Demme explains.
I'm a very strong supporter, and I try to create an atmosphere of total freedom for the actors to explore the part as much as they possibly can. I try to make good little suggestions as infrequently as possible. You'll never hear me say, your motivation in this scene is.
People will say we're in love.
I work only with actors who have a very, very, very strong sense of what they want to do with the part.
You use every skin cream. And sometimes you wear lead at home. But not today.
Director Sidney Lumet had a similar approach with actors, creating an environment that was all in the service of one goal, self-revelation. He describes working with Paul Newman on The Verdict.
We finished a run-through and we sat down afterwards. I asked Paul to stay. And he said, it's not working, is it? And I said, not quite, Paul. And he said, well, what do you think's wrong? And I said, well, there's nothing that I can help you with here, Paul. There's an element in this guy that you've got to let us see. And that means letting us see that element in you.
Now listen to me, Phil.
No, you listen to me. All I want on this trial was a fair shake. Okay? Push me into court 5 days early. I lose my star witness, and I can't get a continuance, and I don't care. I'm going up there, I'm gonna try it, I'm gonna let the jury decide. You know, they told me about you. Said you're a hard ass, you're a defendant's judge. Well, I don't care. I said to hell with it, to hell with it!
Ingmar Bergman aimed to have a back-and-forth rapport with actors.
When I work together with the actors, I try to be like a radar. Like I try to be wide open, because we have to make something, create something together. I give them some stimulations and suggestions, and they give me a lot of stimulations and suggestions.
Terrence Malick will take this collaboration even further, often allowing his actors to move away from the script and make their own decisions throughout a scene. Actor Christian Bale explains.
There was a script, but he really never paid any attention to it. Like, he was kind of, let's get rid of that. You know, let's just do this instead. And then gradually just coming to a point where you kind of says, well, you know, what do you think? I mean, I should do something. I'll just give you kind of character description and then just, yeah, off you go. See what happens. I went, great, let's try that. You know, it's fantastic.
But when the prince arrived, the people poured him a cup that took away his memory. He forgot he was the son of the king.
Other filmmakers opt to be a bit more direct. Kelly Fremon discusses her simple approach to working with Hailee Steinfeld and Woody Harrelson in Edge of 17.
They're such incredible actors that you could just give them a sense of, here's what you're trying to accomplish in the scene. Here's how you want to affect the other person. And then, you know, just let them go.
Hey, so just a heads up, but yesterday when you were giving your lecture, you were like, oh, blah, 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 then the North seceded from the Union. You meant to say the South seceded. You accidentally said the exact opposite.
Great catch. Yeah. Now, I know that it was a long lecture and you probably don't recall, but was there any point during it where you thought to yourself, gosh, I wonder what it's like to actually have a life?
Claire Denis, meanwhile, will often focus on physicality. And sometimes this means expressing notes physically. She describes her approach with Robert Pattinson in High Life.
I had to tell him, you know, maybe I had to touch you, maybe, in the process of shooting. I didn't want him to be shocked by that. Mm. Because me, I'm so used to touch everything, the props, the actors, the camera. I have to touch. Mm. Because otherwise, it's so abstract to stand by a camera. But I'm not touching so much. I mean, I'm a discreet person.
For Carl Theodore Dreyer, a close-up can do lots of work for a performance.
I have always liked the close-up of faces. The human face, old or young, is for me a passage, very beautiful and worth studying. I'm very happy when the actor or the actress and I succeed in disclosing the thoughts and the feelings behind the words.
There is no one way for a director to work with an actor. Throughout each stage of the process, a director will decide what approach works best for them, the project and the performer.
All week you've been so excited, your first ever movie.
But no matter what, filmmaking is a collaborative art form, and it falls on an actor's shoulders to deliver the performance you need.
We got plans up here that's gonna take this company into the fucking stratosphere!
Already have an actor in mind? Write them their next great role with StudioBinder's screenwriting software. And don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to stay up to date on all our future videos. Goodbye for now. Remember, they call actors the talent for a reason.
Where I'm having a problem is sometimes the horse comes out and I can't get past the cow. So I have to kind of, you know, do this when I come out. Gather round, for I have news.
I don't know which is more lifelike, the horse or Dr. Pearl.
You.